actually posture-wise, you seem to be sitting in a better position. Have you found your ab engagement is still working?
Yeah, it's coming out going all right. I haven't really had much time to do diet training perhaps, but I can actually...
What's up, guys? So first order of the business of the day, we are getting our body fat taken. What he's doing here, my good friend Ewan, who is helping me with my posing and taking my body fat every 2 weeks, is using skin calipers as a measurement tool to measure my body fat, which, you know, it's not 100% accurate, but if you stay consistent with the measurement tool you use, then it's a good guideline for you to use. And here we're just talking about how the week's gone, you know, progress on my lifts, on my training, my nutrition. And it's just a really good reference point for me, especially in a prep. I do recommend you use a coach that can help you with your training and nutrition if you need help with that. Me personally, I've never done physique competition, so what I need help with was the posing. And you're about to see that in a minute. We're just going through some mandatory poses and then moving into the more bodybuilder style ones that I've got to do for the men's physique show.
I just thought to take you through my breakfast. So I've actually already started it and then I forgot I didn't include it in the video. So what we've got here is 2 pieces of wholemeal toast, 120 grams of egg whites, 1 fried egg, 100 grams of green beans, and then like a handful of spinach, which is maybe like 7 or 8 calories. I'm also going to have 1 fish oil that I have here. So we're using Swiss odorless wild fish oil, so it doesn't leave you with that horrible taste in your mouth. And then we're also going to have 1 cup of coffee and just, you know, I've already drank half of it, but a ton of water. Also, what I like to do when I'm eating my breakfast is catch up on a bit of YouTube. So the video for the day is Rob Lipsit's new vlog. Big fan of Rob Lipsit. I kind of relate to him the way he talks about everything. If you watch his previous videos and just his journey, it's just something that I want to follow. Obviously my part A is not going to be the same as his part A, and that's something that I do recognize, but I do find it quite inspiring and motivating to see how he's, you know, grinded away and he's created like a really good you know, fitness community for himself now.
Deep thinking as well, and just like thinking of the bigger picture, and I've came to really realize that there are very few things that matter in life, and a lot of the times we're worrying over really irrelevant shit. Like when it comes down to it, there's so few shit that actually matters, like friends, family, your health, happiness, well-being. Like, you know, after that it's all just secondary. So odds are if you're worrying about some shit, it's not even important.
Right, one thing I've actually been in need of is some BCAAs. If no one knows what they are, they're branched chain amino acids, and they can assist with training. Basically just keeps your body in a constant supply of amino acids that go straight to the muscle and keep your body in an optimal state for muscle anabolism. And it basically helps you with workouts as well. So what I'm gonna do is just get some for my protein. We'll go for either Berry Blast or Tropical. I'm feeling Tropical. 250 grams, done. Fuck it, I also have been in such need of a bag. I'm a big bag to carry all my stuff in, just in general. So this is jumping in my basket as well. Right, I also need some protein powder. So I'm gonna go for chocolate caramel, just sounds nice. I'm just gonna go for the standard Impact Whey protein. If you compare the Impact Whey protein to the Impact Whey isolate, the only difference is about 10 calories. As you can see there, 103 and 93, so 10 calories and just a very slight difference in carbs and fats. You get like 1 gram of carb and fat, so it's really minimal. It's not gonna make much of a difference, and I am on a budget, so this one's the one for me. Right, last but not least, secret weapon before going to the gym, pink rock salt. What this enables you to do is, by getting a nice hit of sodium before the gym, get you a really nice pump. It's a tip from my coach, and it fucking works. So, good pinch. Done the hatchet.
Let's go.
Guys, welcome to the workout. Starting here with some heavy deadlifts, well, heavy for me at this point in the cut anyway, and then moving on to some heavy rowing and some bicep isolation later in the workout. Hey guys, just a small point on these deadlifts here. For some reason my Achilles was playing up, I could feel it a tiny bit, and I did a lot of foam rolling, but it was irritating me, so I backed off on the weight a tiny bit on these deadlifts and just really focused on my form and engaging my lats, and I got just as good of a workout. I have done about 185 kilograms for 2 or 3 reps before. This I think is around 160, so it's a lot less, but you have to remember, I have been cutting and losing body fat. You are going to lose some strength, but keep the form good, keep the weights fairly high, and you'll still make gains. Right guys, time for some posing here. As we can see, looking fairly tight. The results from the body fat, as we said earlier, were around 6.5%, maybe 6%. It is skin calipers though, so it's not 100% accurate. As we can see here though, like looking fairly lean. This video was actually taken like during the workout, like so this back is fairly pumped up from deadlifts and pull-ups I did. I just got some random guy to record this, it was pretty funny. But yeah, as we can see, those carbs that I had the night before really doing me well there. Really leaned out, looking very full, looking very big and vascular. See some striations coming through there. But yeah, this prep's been going well. The calories I was on previous to this day, I think, was around 2700, 2750. So yeah, decent calorie range. As we can see here, back is definitely a decent point. As you can see, the waist isn't the smallest of waists. I think especially in that video, the erector spinae muscles, like all the lower erectors are very pumped up, and it's just going to pump up the waist a bit more. But I mean, as long as I've got the thickness and the size, it doesn't really matter. Everyone's got their own structure and proportion.
Condition is definitely coming in. Time to take it to the next level. Basically, it's been absolutely shit weather in Sydney the past 2 weeks. Raining, a bit cold, feels basically like England again. And now look. Feels like 23 degrees maybe. Nice to have a little bit of summer back. Right guys, post-workout nutrition. We got 150 grams of chicken breast with cooked in some garlic and oregano. We've got 200 grams of sweet potato. And we've got 150 grams of broccoli with about 100 grams, it's underneath here, of like frozen mixed vegetables with a big glass of water. I've already eaten, had a protein shake with some oats and a banana, so that gives me my high glycemic carbs and some slow digesting carbs with a mixture of protein to recover from that workout, about usually about 50 to 100 grams of carbs, about 40 grams of protein. And now this is gonna fill me up before work. I'm just walking back from work right now. Everyone else is going out to party, get drunk, have a fucking lit time. But I am going to go home, prep some meals for tomorrow because I'm working all day and I'm actually in the car. Prep some meals and go to bed. Get the life of a physique athlete. Feels when you walk past trays of cookies and you're cutting in a calorie deficit. A little bit of meal prep done for the weekend and tomorrow. As we can see here, we actually have some about 200 grams of basa fillet with some oregano that was cooked in, that is gorgeous by the way. And then here we've got 200 grams of sweet potato, 200 grams of like frozen vegetables that were cooked in the microwave. All in all, pretty healthy meal. That's the same but with chicken. And 50 grams extra sweet potato. Yeah, so as we can see there, 216 protein, 285 carbs, and 50 grams of fat, about 2,500 calories. It's time to get serious, it's time to start depleting a bit. This protein is a tiny bit high. I might lower that a little bit and add it to carbs in the next few days. We'll see.
Right guys, if you enjoyed that video, make sure to like and subscribe. Also go follow me at Josh King Fitness on Instagram. I enjoyed making this video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it, and I'm gonna endeavor to produce some really top quality videos in the coming couple of weeks and near future. So like, subscribe, follow me. Peace, see you in the next one.